Sabu. Come on, Van Damme. Fonzie, bring your scrawny ass out, brother. Come on out and talk to Taz. I'm ready to fight. Sabu and I are the main event tonight. I don't want to wait until the end of the night. All right. Fonzie, when you step in this ring, you have about 15 seconds to live. You got 15 seconds, motherfucker. I'm gonna choke you out. So come talk to me. I give you my word. I ain't gonna touch your ass because I want Sabu. Come talk to me. 15 seconds.
Hey, first of all, fat boy, you missed the boat. You missed the boat because you see, we're on Monday night, we're getting set this big, and there's no reason for Sabu to come out here.
Taz is hurt enough of Alfonso.
Come on, baby.
He's gonna Taz flex him.
That's what you call choking a chicken.
Sabu has hit the ring.
I'm saying.
There's the bell. It's time for the grudge rematch of the century. This matchup, also originally scheduled for the pay-per-view on August 17th. But these two men couldn't wait. Both feet in the face of Taz. Cover. Sabu going for a cover early on in the matchup.
Sabu is desperate to even the score from barely legal.
Well, then he had better avoid the kata hajime as if it were the plague. The pass locks it on, it's over. Lane shot kick. Two count only.
Every time Sabu gets Taz down, he's going for a cover. He's desperate for a victory.
Sabu now choking away at Taz. Taz grabs a handful of face, puts a thumb right in the eye. And can you believe the nerve of Alfonso wearing a Monday Night Raw hat to the ECW arena?
Got no class whatsoever.
Tip up. And Taz counter. Now it's Taz putting the boots to Sabu.
It doesn't take Taz any time to even up the score, does it?
Taz has got to stay one step ahead of Sabu because his former manager, Phil Alfonso, who knows many of his training secrets, is now in the corner of Sabu, and vicious cross-facing going on. Taz looking to break the nose of Sabu again, as he did at Barely Legal.
Taz has taken Sabu down to the mat where he needs to keep him to win this match.
Taz locks in the red hook ringer.
And that's what you call a bridge.
Do you believe that that man who's bridging in that fashion had a broken neck at one time?
I can't even believe he had a neck at one time.
You are watching the most eagerly anticipated confrontation in the history of ECW, and dare I say, in the history of all professional wrestling, a grudge rematch from our first pay-per-view, Barely Legal. These two men couldn't wait for our second pay-per-view on August 17th. They wanted to get it on here tonight at WrestlePalooza. Cross kick to the knee.
That was a smart move by Sabu, taking Big Taz off his feet.
Well, if the knee buckles, he can't throw those Taz flexes.
Exactly. With no knee, he has no balance. With no balance, he has no leverage. And leverage and balance are the two most important things to a mat wrestler like Taz.
Taz trying to walk it off. off on the outside, takes the baseball slide to the chest. Acai moonsault, and Taz gets sandwiched into the guardrail.
That's what you call a kamikaze move. Both men down, and Sabu began on the offense.
There you see Bill Alfonso, who at one time was one of the most respected referees all over the world. He became the manager of Taz at the November to Remember 1995, only to betray the human suplex machine on April 13th of this year at Barely Legal on pay-per-view.
There's Sabu going for the cover again.
But Taz kicks out.
Sabu senses he's got to take Taz out real soon, otherwise he's in deep trouble.
Another lateral press and another two count. Hard to tell if Sabu actually thought he had Taz beat or if he just wants Taz to exert the energy of kicking out. Sabu is going for the triple jump move, calling it backfire.
That's exactly why it's called a high-risk maneuver.
Taz has Sabu cinched up. Sabu holding on for dear life. T-bone Taz flex. Then Taz capitalized.
He's got to cover him to beat him.
Sabu can't even stand. Taz says this is it. Sabu trying to fight off the T-bone. Now Taz fighting off the T-bone. Waist lock. Thunder Lights, Taz flexing the bridge. And Sabu pushed away the foot of Taz to kick out.
That's what makes Sabu so dangerous. Not only is he great in the air, but he knows how to counter mat maneuvers.
Taz going up with a fist to the face.
Taz held on. I guess he can counter those aerial maneuvers himself.
Where in the hell is Taz going? No water in the pool. Taz went for the senton splash and missed. Drop from the heaven.
That was a major mistake by Taz going high.
But he still manages to get the shoulder up.
Taz needs to take Sabu back down to the mat.
Alfonso threw a table to Sabu. Taz has cut off Sabu reversal on the Irish whip. Leapfrog. Waistlock. That was low. DDT. Sabu setting up a table. And you can hear Alfonso screaming, he has been waiting for this.
Benedict Arnold.
This is not where Taz wants to be. Sabu switches direction in midair and puts Taz through the table.
Both Taz and the table crumble from Sabu's force.
And that may be all for the human suplex machine. Sabu may have evened this series at one. No! It's the count to Hajime! Sabu flips backwards!
Taz's shoulders were down on the mat. He's got the hold, but his shoulders were down for a three count.
Well, the match is over, but Taz isn't letting go of the count to Hajime! He's got the late great mind as well!
It's like Taz lost the battle, but he's winning the war! He refuses to let go!
I don't think he knows the match is over!
I don't think he cares.
choking out the referee.
Has a snap.
That was his first loss since September 1695, when he came back to Orly for a broken neck.
There goes another referee. Apparently, Taz is upset about this.
Oh, just a bit. He's been undefeated since the November to Remember of 1995.
Nevertheless, Sabu was on the receiving end.
The referees have been choked out, and Sabu has been choked unconscious. And now Taz is choking out Bill Alfonso.
Everybody in the ring, your job is done for the night. Take a walk and let the next fucking match get in there. Get the fuck out and let the next match. I'm sitting up here to enjoy myself. I've seen enough of your ass. Get the fuck out. Well, Shane. Obviously, for such an intelligent man with a little penis, you don't pay attention too well, brother. This is a very simple gimmick. If you would like me to leave my ring, why don't you come and make me leave? Brother, as much as I would like to come down there and teach you how to throw a suplex proper, what the fuck do I get out of it if I come down there and sweat? I've already shown all these assholes what a great athlete I am by taking a very competent rookie and stretching his ass. I get nothing by coming down there and showing you what wrestling is all about. So, you want to play? Let's make a deal. That sounds cool. I got a deal for you, Shane. If you come in this ring and face me face to face, I guarantee you, I could make you tap out within 5 minutes. 5 minutes, brother.
Brother, you got a fucking confidence the size of this building, because you ain't got it in you, brother. I tell you what, I'll be willing to put the belt on the line.
We're gonna sweeten the part a little bit further.
Wait, let's back up one little bit, brother. Did you say that belt that little rat is holding, you're gonna put on the line? That belt you're gonna put against me in this ring tonight?
16 pounds of gold, Taz, but I'm the deal maker here. You're not in the driver's seat, I am. If I last the 5 minutes with you, which is a fucking foregone conclusion, you take your fucking ass out of ECW for a 30-day vacation and let your family fucking starve, big man. Huh? Is that simple enough for an idiot like you to understand? 30 fucking days.
Okay, all right, so let me get this straight. You come here, you face me for that belt. If I don't make you tap out, I leave for 30 days without pay. Well, I'll tell you what, brother. Let's make it 60 days. 60 days, brother.
Brother, you're dumber than you fucking look.
Yeah, I'm dumb.
60 days, your family, no food on the table. Brother, you better have a savings account, because your family's going to fucking starve.
Well, the only way to find out if my family's going to starve is for you to get your narrow ass in this ring.
Let's just clarify. 5 minutes. I don't tap out. You walk out the fucking door, and I don't go to look at your greasy ass for 60 days.
Yes, that's right. 60 days. I'll tell you what. Being that I'm in a very angry mood today, and being that you're so fond of something, now listen up. I'll up the ante just a little bit more, brother. And then I'm done with this shit, because I'm going to come up there and bust your ass, his ass, and her ass. Now, here's the deal. 60 days, I'm gone without pay. And also, you come here now, put that fucking belt on a line. I won't make you tap in 5 minutes. Being that you're so fond of this number, I won't make you tap in 3 minutes, Shane.
Brother, strap him up tight. You got yourself a
bring
fucking
it,
deal.
Bring it.
Go get him, Shane. Go get him. Go.
The net of everything we just ran through is this. If Taz chokes out Shane Douglas in 3 minutes or less, he's the new World Television Champion. If he does not, then he's got to find another way to feed his family for the next 45 days because he's out of here.
Was a questionable move by Taz, but downright stupid on the part of Douglas. Douglas has nothing to gain here.
And everything to lose. And Taz has already wrestled a match against Sabu, of all people.
Needless to say, Taz has been worn down, but this is stupid on the part of Shane Douglas. He should stick and move, stay away from Taz, and let the clock run out.
Well, his ego may be getting the best of him.
Maybe he's trying to prove to Francine, after all, he is a man.
30 seconds down. Swinging neck breaker. The franchise knows that Taz has had a broken neck, and nobody breaks necks like the franchise.
Nobody's got a neck like Taz either.
DDT. We are now a full minute. Oh my God.
Excellent move by Shane Douglas.
An inverted rolling neck. We've got less than 2 minutes. Oh, not again. We have got less than 2 minutes to go in this special challenge.
He's focused on the neck of Taz.
90 seconds into the match.
We are halfway through. We are a minute 30 into this 3 minute challenge. Full Nelson now by the franchise. Taz goes for the countdown today. The franchise blocks the right arm and goes downstairs.
It was a gutsy challenge by Taz, who maybe was trying to spin a web and catch a fly. Whether or not he has the gas left in him remains to be seen.
Reversal! There it is!
There's the cut to Hajime! He's got it locked on! The Taz mission, the cut to Hajime, is locked on the World Television Champion!
We have got 1 minute to go! Can the franchise hold on? He's trying desperately to reach the ropes! But Taz has the hope since done. Douglas's legs are not long enough. He cannot reach the ropes. Less than 1 minute to go. Can the franchise hang on? Can he fight off the cup to Hajime?
Shane Douglas has to feel that title belt slipping from his grasp as every second ticks off the clock.
30 seconds left. Can the franchise... Taz keeps trying to hook that leg. The franchise keeps kicking it away.
He's back up to his feet.
He's going to try to kick backwards like Sabu.
He's locked the legs.
He tapped. The franchise tapped out. won the ECW World Television Championship.
Would be afraid to dive into the drink behind me. But you see, with Francine by me, I'm fearless. With Francine behind me, I'll swim with the sharks. I'll tread where most men would not tread. You see, Taz, you talk about how tough you are, and indeed you are, and most men in this sport would be afraid to face you. But I wasn't. Just like going into this dark water, I treaded down to the ring to face you one-on-one, Taz. But you see, I played a mind game with you. You thought you beat the franchise? You couldn't do it on my worst day and your best. Taz, what you did was you stepped in and played a mental chess game, only half prepared. And you lost. You see, Taz, what happened was Francine and I got sick and tired of carrying around 15, 16 pounds of fake gold plating. It was turning Francine's skin green, and it just doesn't look good on her. So what I did, Taz, is I made a plan. You see, one thing about the franchise that somebody should have told you through that thick skull of yours is that I do better than anybody else is I manipulate people. I set the stage so that I cannot lose. And so what did I want to do, Taz? I felt like losing. I took a walk down to the aisle with the incomparable Taz, the human suplex machine, the toughest man in ECW. And I tapped out. Are you starting to see the picture? Is it starting to become clear to you, Taz? I did the job. I took a fall. You see, I didn't take the easy way out, like Mike Tyson, and bite half your ear off, because that wouldn't have gotten me what I wanted. And I wanted relieved of 16 pounds of copper plating. Copper gold plating. And so you, Taz, I bequeath the world's television title on you, the human suplex machine. Ain't you great? We want 16 pounds of gold, not gold plating. And so, Terry Funk, that brings me to you. You've got something that I want, and more importantly, what Francine wants. You see, when we slip between the sheets at night, and we have the fun that only Franchise and Francine can have, something has been missing lately, and it's been wild, it's been sweaty, we've been dripping and dropping all over the place, we've been having a good time, but something's missing. World's heavyweight champion written backwards. Terry Funk, you got what I want. It's my belt. And 3 years ago, I made it my belt. I took a 3-year vacation, Terry Funk, and I'm coming back for what's mine. I let you hold it for a while. I let Scotty hold it for a while. I let Sandman hold it for a while. I let Mikey Whipwreck hold it for a while. But nobody has blazed the trail like I've done it here. Nobody in this sport. Taz, I tapped out for you because I didn't want the belt anymore. Terry Funk, I'm coming for you. After I take a swim in this drink, you're all mine, Terry Funk, because 53 years old, and I don't give a goddamn how tough you are. I'm a man driven. I'm a man driven by perspiration, a man driven by athleticism, a man driven by history. I'm a man with a great woman behind me. Terry Funk, see you around, old man. See you around.